Without further ado, start asking questions.
First question.
First of all, thanks for coming. And second of all, I hope you enjoyed the movie. And third of all, you remember George. My name is
Sheriff McClellan, if you will.
But anyway, we could answer anything you want. I remember coming here.
Within reason.
Yes. My Saturday, I'll tell you what, I worked at 7-Eleven for a long time in case you're out of town. On Saturday, I got up at 8 and I cut the grass, took care of the yard, went to the TV station normally at 4 o'clock. I did wrestling live from 6 to 7:30. At 8 o'clock, there was a Catholic church nearby. I'm Catholic. I'd go to the Mass for a half hour. Came back up. On Chiller Theater, I was on. I did the weather at 11, but I was also the only announcer on the TV. And at the 11:30, Chiller Theater started. And Chiller, my belief on that was not to come out as Dracula or something, come out as Bill Cardille. I wanted to wear a tuxedo. And then about Bill and three. So, I was supposed to, when, not George didn't call me, but Russ.
Russ Schreiner?
Marilyn and
Marilyn and Carl.
Yeah, Carl. Carl called me. He said, Bill, we're making a movie, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I says, hey, I am so busy. In those days, a lot of people were making movies at Super 8. And I says, I go to Philadelphia every Tuesday to do a show there. I'm so busy, I can't do it. But thanks anyway, good luck. I can help you. About a week goes by, the phone rings, it's Carl. Right. Carl was a wonderful human being. And Carl called me and said, Bill, I got to ask you a favor. So anyway, we talked and talked, and I said, I can't make it. I'm tied up here, so what do we work out? When you're done with Chiller in the morning, 3 o'clock, come on out. We'll take you when the sun comes up. Flash ahead. Get off the air. We go for a couple of eggs. Get up here at 6 o'clock. Sun comes up at 7 o'clock, and I have a couple buddies with me, Steve Hutzko, a cameraman, and my director at the time, good friend Chuck Moyer. We sit down, they have a soap outside in a messy house. So we're sitting there, so then everybody gets up slow and I see the truck that was half burned and looking around. And then finally they all get up. And George and Russ came over and said, Bill, you're gonna be the first one as soon as that sun comes up, and then they're good, because I've been up since 8 o'clock the previous morning. Well, I'll fast forward. For lunch, we had baked beans and hot dogs, which I love. Anyway, about 6 o'clock in the evening, you know, they said, we're ready. So that's how I met George and the fellas with the guns, and we went over, and I think we took one take.
I think so.
Yeah, one take. George told me what to do and et cetera, et cetera. And I told Steve, stand here, hold the camera. We did the bit. I got home that night about 7:30. I have four brothers and four sisters, and they knew that Sundays I'm usually off. And when I got home, my one brother, Jack, and his five kids, they waited till 10 o'clock in the morning to visit with me. But I said, we'll do it again sometime. Anyway, the association was beautiful, wonderful. I'll tell you a quick one. When they got the first print, Russ called me and said, hey, Duquesne is having a break. And it's a spring break. They're all getting out of school tomorrow. Why don't the two of us go up and we'll watch the movie? So I watched it for the first time. You never know what you get in a movie. Anyway, we ran the movie and the college kids went crazy. And it's pretty good. It's going to be great. So they package it, boom, they have a grand opening. Grand opening was downtown Pittsburgh. I did the money movie every day from 4 till 6. Right after the money movie, I said, I have to go home and change. Pick me up. So they picked me up in limo, And while they come out, my daughter Lori, right here with the camera, and my young son Bill were very young at the time, and the driver of the limo took them around the block and waited. So I get there just before curtain time, and I didn't know what to expect. Well, they ran the movie, and when it came on, I wanted to hear what I said. I didn't know. I didn't know too much about it. So anyway, when I come on, everybody starts cheering and clapping and hollering, and there is, I don't know what I said. But we went up to the William Penn, and they had a nice big house party there. It was terrific, and it was nice. The movie in town made most of their money back, because they put up money and themselves, and you know, we were making like $200 a week, so you can tell how busted they were. Anyway, one other thing. When the movie came out and it was a hit here, they released it. And you know the movie Psycho. Psycho was released. The company that released it, the company, took Night of the Living Dead, and yeah, they have to distribute it. So I know you don't know this story. I don't even know if it was ever printed. But what happened with that? The movie ran for 6 months. It had some, and you know Siskel and Ebert? But the fat one, I don't know his name.
Roger Ebert.
I haven't watched him for Ebert says on the air, one of the worst movies I've ever seen. This movie is called Night of the Living Dead. This is what I was told by George. This was wrong, this was wrong, this was wrong. Yeah, well, don't waste your time. So Reader's Digest had books that they put out different reviews in. They put that review in Reader's Digest.
Right.
And when the book came out, guess what? Everybody wanted to go see the movie, and now it's over.
Yep.
Now you know.
And Mother Nature's camping on
that. Where's your gun?
Cisco.
And Ebert. Anyway, mine is a little different than Bill's, because I was the production manager on the film, crewed on it, invested in it, and played the sheriff. And the way I played the sheriff was strange, because we were sitting there casting people, and Rudy Ritchie's cousin, Richard, mentioned that I looked like a cop. That's it, I'm the sheriff. So, okay, I'm the sheriff, what are we doing? Instead of carrying boxes, now I'm in front of a camera. And my family said, you want us to put money in it? What do you know about making a movie? You know, you don't know nothing. Go to school, learn. I said, I am going to school. I've been there since 1961. And they wouldn't believe it, so nobody invested. And I'm glad they didn't, because the distributor stole the money anyway. But
10 years.
The one thing that really impressed me with the entire operation, everyone, regardless of what they were doing, did not say, that's not my job, I'm not doing it. Everyone said, what else do you need me to do? What do you want? How else can I help? What more do you need? And that made it a joy, not a job. We had incidents that were hilarious. Like, we went to Washington, D.C. to photograph the general and the scientist being interviewed. We had Carl Hardman's Lincoln Town Car. When we got into D.C., we had it washed. We parked on the street in front of the military police, got out of the car, took the front license plate on, off, and put the general's plate on. And while we're doing that, one of the MPs came over, looked at us, didn't question it, and he says, the general can park over there if you like. And we did. So now that we don't have a dressing room. So in the middle of a street in downtown Washington, D.C., with the Capitol as a backdrop, we formed a circle in the middle of the street, They're all holding up blankets. The actor playing the general got in the middle of the circle, undressed, put on his uniform. Not one person questioned us. The Washington, D.C. police, the MPs, the SPs, the White House guards, nobody said, where's your permits? What are you doing? They just got out of the way and let us do it. I don't think you could get away with that this year.
I remember George saying we got in the car and we drove 80 miles an hour to get the hell out of there. Because they all of a sudden knew that it was somebody making a move.
Yeah.
Any questions? That's what we're here for. Yes.
Yeah, I came from the D.C. area. I may have retraced your steps, you know, but on the highway. How much of your big scene was scripted, you know, an improv? I heard there was a little of both, or?
No script.
No script.
You have a script?
I improvised that line, they're dead, they're all messed up. That was not in the script. I felt like saying it, so I said it.
He didn't know what I was going to say. George just set the scene. You know, just I think I saw some of the shots from the day, and he said, this is the sheriff, and we're going to attack the house, et cetera, et cetera, and let's go. So I did my thing, and I got my cameraman, which was lucky. He had a little camera in those days, that's what we did, shooting film. Because I did come up and do two promotional spots
here,
saying there's a movie being made in Pittsburgh.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And Steve was the best photographer. So I said, hey, Steve, come along. So anyway, he held the camera, and we did our thing. I don't think we did do tapes. I don't remember so long ago.
I don't recall either. I think we got it in
one. He was dynamite. He's hooked up. He's scared.
We're good. He is. I'm
no, it was good. And that's why I said I wanted to. I never went to any of the previews and that until I went to, as a group, it was a
world premiere.
The world premiere. But when we went to Duchesne, that was a screen. I mean, it was hijacked from California where they all mixed. And nobody knew that they took one of those. So even Russ was looking at it. But they were a good team. Russ Schreiner and George Romero were a good team. And they did a couple of other movies. My daughter, Lori. My daughter, Lori. she was in New York. She starred on Edge of Night. She's on Broadway with Jessica Tandy. Sid did a lot of commercials a long time ago when Merrill Lynch had those bulls. She went to England, did the commercials. She was also the prince.
Okay, Dad. I love you. I'm proud of you too.
Okay. Anyway, that Day of the Dead, she was in a play off Broadway, and George goes to see it. And after the show, he says, "Hey, I want to take you out and have dinner." She says, "Well, I'll bring my husband along, Jim Rogel. He's from Pittsburgh. They met in New York." So they're at dinner, and he says, "Boy, you were really good up there. That was nice." And you're from Pittsburgh. I never met you. Yes, you did.
Or,
I did? When? He told him about the limousine ride. And they talked about it. He didn't know my car was on the air. He wrote Day of the Dead with four people. Lori was 4 or 5 months pregnant. And she says, you know, so anyway, she says, I'm 4 months pregnant. Didn't show it. He says, I'm going to rewrite it. There'll be one girl and you're the girl. So won 2 awards in Spain and in France, and I won't say another thing.
Okay. It was very nice of you, Bill.
What's your question now? It's pretty hot.
Yeah.
Hot. Anybody? Yes.
What was your favorite part of doing it?
You know, I like the people. I'm a people person. And we sat around on the inside in that living room there. And we talked, and then they'd get up and go shoot something. And my favorite scene, I don't have any one particular, but, you know, Dave James is here today. He worked with me at Channel 11 before he went to KV. And he came up, and he was good as a zombie. He died so quick. Oh, fantastic. And also, so anyway, I was shocked at the end, getting shot. Did you expect the star to get shot? I did. And that was a questionable question, but it hurt everybody. Now, you know, a follow-up. I was doing chiller. I had a lot of food. Go to bed, the movies are over. Some night are in three movies. In those days, the stations went on 24 hours through the country. So the signal bounced. And I had letters from Canada, from Pittsburgh, Canada, Fort Knox, Chicago, New York, because no other stations were on. And I'd read those letters on. But when this movie came out, I was getting mail from Greenland. I had so many of them. Teachers, a lot of teachers overseas. I remember in Spain there'd be, Chile, I'm from Fox Chapel, I'm teaching in Madrid. And, boy, you speak perfect Spanish. I got it from Japan, I got it from Germany, I got it from everywhere. And I don't know, it just kept coming and coming. But I did not know that it was going to become as big as that. I really haven't. No matter, it's the start of the zombies. And they say that you like chiller theaters. You have that type of movie. I love them. The reason I went off in 84, after 21, 22 years, the longest running role, you know, the reason I went off, the movies, the chiller type movies, they were dash and slash. All this, we can't show that to kids. I mean, we did it. And we ran. I scheduled the movies after about 5 years.